Hello viewers, hope you are doing great. Welcome to our channel. I am back with a new destination which we have explored in a budget friendly manner. Today we will share our Ottawa visit experience and tips and tricks. You got it right, Canada Revenue Agency CRA is located over here. So are you planning to reduce your tax? Just kidding. There are lots of amazing places to explore in Ottawa. Let's go there. Let's first discuss where Canada's capital is located. Well, it is situated in the east of southern Ontario, near the city of Montreal and US border, right beside the Ottawa River. Your travel plan will depend from which province or city you are traveling. If planning to fly, then need to arrive Ottawa International Airport. If you are traveling from Greater Toronto Area or GTA, the cheapest option would be by driving. It is around 450 kilometers away from Toronto and will take around 4 hours 15 minutes. Also, another way is via rail from Toronto, which will take around 5 hours, and fare is 49 CAD, which is not that much. I will add the reservation link in the description. We drove from Mississauga and it took around 4 hours 30 minutes. We have started early in the morning, 5:30 AM, and took a break in teams and reached there at around 11 AM. Once you reach, park the car at Darcy McGee Building, Lot 44. I will add the address in description box. There are lots of awesome attractions to explore and you will enjoy walking in downtown, taking pictures, doing fun. Few attractions are free of cost and few with tickets. Our first stop was Notre Dame Basilica, and you also want to include in your list. Entry is free. I never seen such beautiful structure. The Gothic Revival structure is full of eye-catching design. We took some great pictures over there. Our second stop was National Gallery of Canada. It is located just opposite to the Basilica. The gallery is home to a world-class collection that includes centuries of Canadian and European art. It has entry fee of $16. If you don't want to go inside, still you can take photos with the Mammon, the large bronze spider in front of the gallery. I'll add the gallery website link in the description. The third stop were Parliament Hill and buildings. A grand Victorian architecture. Its Gothic Revival suite of buildings is the home of Parliament of Canada and has architectural element of national symbolic importance. Don't miss the centennial flame in front of the building. Observe the Peace Tower, also known as the Tower of Victory and Peace. It is a focal bell and clock tower, sitting on the central axis of the center block of Canadian Parliament buildings. Next, we went to Hogback Falls. It's just 10 minutes drive from the hills. You will see these beautiful falls for free. You should go there and take some breathtaking pictures. Next, we visited National War Memorial. It is also known as the Response. It is a cenotaph symbolizing the sacrifice of all Canadian Armed Force personnel. It's free of cost. Well, how can we miss Rideau Canal when we are in Ottawa trip? It is filled with boats in summer and ice skaters in winter. One of the must-see places we have visited during falls, so it was colorful and vibrant. We took water taxi ride, $10 per person, which took us to the other side of the Ottawa River, that is basically Quebec province. It was feeling amazing floating on Ottawa River, that is in between of two provinces. The water taxi driver dropped us in Gretigny, Quebec, and given us time to explore. There you can visit Canadian Museum of History Gretigny. When we reached there, it just closed, so took some pictures from outside and went for a fantastic walk on the Prince of Wales Bridge. Then our final destination was Ottawa Sign, Bayard Market. It was fun to visit there. People were singing, dancing, and enjoying their life. Don't forget to take the picture with the Ottawa Sign. Meanwhile, if you feel hungry, there are plenty of good restaurants in downtown. As we drove, so packed our car with full of foods, drinks, and snacks, which has given us flexibility to explore more places in shorter duration. Other than that, there are lots of museums which you can explore. There are Canadian War Museum, Canada's World War Museum, Canada Aviation and Space Museum are there to explore with ticket. I will add the website URL for all the museums in description. After spending an awesome day, we drove 40 minutes to reach Ardmore and stayed there. Stay connected to know why we choose to stay at Ardmore instead of Ottawa, and how it helped us to explore Algonquin Provincial Park in a better way. Hope you also enjoyed your visit, or these tips will help you to explore the place in a better way. Let me know in the comment section your experience, or if you have any questions. If you like this video, show your love. See you next week with the details of colorful Algonquin and other cost-cutting tips.